This is bigger than basketball. None of us win until we all do. So we'll always fight like hell. This is bigger than one name on a jersey or hashtag. When you see us, know that we're representing for all of them. This is bigger than our jump shots. This is bigger than our stats. This is bigger than our championship. We're the WNBA, and we're bigger than ball.
We welcome you to beautiful Bradenton here on a Sunday night, where today the Phoenix Mercury take on the Washington Mystics. And taking a look at where we stand heading into the second half of the 2020 WNBA season, not a lot of separation between 6 through 10, less than two games between being in the playoffs and out of the playoffs with under 3 weeks to play in the regular season. And with that, we welcome you into our broadcast tonight. Sean Salisbury and Leah Secondo with you. And Leah, some big news coming out from Phoenix yesterday saying that after not playing Friday due to personal reasons, Brittany Griner has left the bubble, and that is all that they will comment on this time. We hope Brittany and her family are doing okay throughout this entire process. But now Phoenix has to move forward and shift its focus back on the regular season. How does this change their personnel and what they're going to run the rest of the season?
Well, they'll probably go with a faster set, a three-guard set most of the time. And with that in part, it will be up to Bria Hartley to kind of take the load on that. The last four games, Bria Hartley has averaged over 20-plus points. She's extremely versatile, Sean, and I think those multi-positions that she can play will help fill the gap with Brittany Griner out of the lineup. Now, Hartley is also an offensive key cog. She can push the ball up the floor as well, get things going in transition, and give Skylar Diggins and Diana Taurasi a little bit more room of comfort to move.
And while Hartley looks like a potential most improved player in the WNBA this year, here's another one, Myesha Hines-Allen, who has become a true leader on and off the floor for Mike Tebow.
Setting new standards, really, this season from a year ago, nearly tripling her point output, 29 points per game in the last two games. But I think that over the last six, this is a longevity thing, this marathon that we're playing here in the bubble. And her presence as a leader, both vocally and by example, will be huge tonight. 11, 10-plus games this season for Hines-Allen.
And as we take a look at the starting lineup, Diana Taurasi changing her number in honor of Kobe Bryant's birthday. The L.A. native wearing number 8. And what a great scene as she revealed it just moments ago before taking the floor.
Very tight with Kobe and Gigi, and a nice, real nice touch tonight as the entire weekend dedicated to Kobe's birthday, and tomorrow will be Mamba Day. And the WNBA players from the hotel through their game garb and everything that they're doing this weekend, all in honor of a gentleman who has meant so much, not only to the WNBA, but to all of women's sports in promoting the game.
Brianna Turner, Myesha Hines-Allen to jump. The tap one. Second-year forward out of Notre Dame. Our officials tonight, Roy Gulbayan, Tiffany Bird, and Carlina Tobin. Taurasi, long pass inside to Turner. Wasn't ready. She finds Kia Vaughn, and she sticks the early jumper. As Leah mentioned, a lot less size going to be on the floor in a thin front court for Phoenix. Trying to free up Kiara Leslie. Myesha Hines-Allen commits the foul, trying to screen Taurasi.
Diana Taurasi a little blindsided there. And, you know, something that Sandy Brondello had said prior to the game tonight was she felt as though the last 72 hours, really, with this team, they've had some of their best conversations and talks about how to proceed forward without Brittany Griner on a team.
5 seconds on the shot clock. Skylar Diggins-Smith weaves inside. Kick out to Hartley. And nothing but air there on her first shot attempt today. And this is Phoenix, where they've lost three straight, 4-5. And as we just showed you the standings earlier, A game and a half separates Phoenix in sixth place and Washington in 10th. So like you mentioned, you can't take any days off because you can slip up, and that might be the difference between making or missing the playoffs.
Well, we saw it a little bit earlier today with Atlanta taking care of Minnesota after being down.
Ariel Atkins connects on the three, coming off a strong 18-point performance Friday. And there's a steal on the perimeter. Leslie to the basket, lost the handle, but got her own miss. Put back attempt won't go, turn. Hauls it in and finds Taurasi. Quick outlet to Skylar Diggins-Smith. Good recovery by Washington, forcing the turnover.
Great recovery by Washington. That was something that Mike Tebow really emphasized after his team's last performance, that, you know, we're just not coming with the energy. He goes, you know, I understand our team is young, but we've got to show urgency, not get ourselves down so early in games that we're in these huge holes, and play with some heart and some desire. And he's been going with some different lineups and some different looks with this young team, just trying to see who really wants to be out on the floor for him right now.
Miscommunication forces another pass out of bounds. Leah, what are you looking out for in this game tonight?
Well, I think Phoenix certainly needs to push the tempo and be consistent with that tempo, going faster in their motion, their offensive set. Washington has to hit the board. This is a good rebounding Phoenix team and need to play with urgency, as we discussed. Don't take any possessions off.
Rossi misfires. Turner couldn't tap it to a teammate. Here's Hines Allen coming off a 35-point performance where she took over in the second half on Friday in a loss to Dallas. A three on the way. That's no good from Tiana Hopkins. These teams trying to feel each other out in the first of two meetings in the next 5 days. Diggins-Smith too strong. Hopkins follows the rebound. Atkins sporting the Kobe's on her feet today. Working around is Washington, looking to improve to 5-8 tonight. Deep in the shot clock, nothing going inside. Atkins puts it up and gets the bounce.
Something Mike Tebow talked about a little bit earlier was, you know, they were talking about the potential quote-unquote intimidation of Taurasi and Skylar Diggins, and Mike came back right away and said, you know, Atkins has seen these players, you know, it's nothing new to her. She's got to be able to attack and finish, and that was exactly what she did on that play.
Up ahead, Hartley is denied by Leslie.
Getting back quickly, good timing there on the ball, and a good job to knock that one away without getting a foul called at all. Got to be able to protect the basketball going up left like that with your other hand.
Foul called against Leslie. And that ought to be an encouraging sign from Coach Tebow. I thought you cleaned it up a moment ago when you were talking about some of his comments from Friday's game, because he came out and said, our defense was garbage in the first half. And he's trying to challenge his team that, despite not having Emma Meesum in Friday and dealing with a couple of other injuries, on top of who he doesn't have on his roster like he had a year ago, he's not making any excuses.
No, you know, and this is really like a training camp for what he has left of a roster right now. And it's, unfortunately, trial by fire against some of the best veterans in the world. But that's how you get better as a player, too. Could be painful, but in the long run, could be good.
Meesemann was listed as questionable coming into today's game. She is on the bench, but wouldn't be surprised if we didn't see her today. As the weaving right through the defense, Kiara Leslie lays it in. Megan Smith off the screen, puts in her first basket of the game. Mitchell, nice hezzy. Trying to pass inside. It is last off of a Phoenix defender. Washington will keep it. Still a little sloppy start for each of these teams.
Well, and you know, Leilani Mitchell had that huge gap going to the hoop, but knew better that there was a taller person lurking in her background there, would have swatted that ball away if she had put it up.
Hawkins floats it up. Hines Allen, offensive rebound, and the putback. Coming off the first ever Washington mixed stick performance of 35 points and 12 rebounds. Megan Smith caught along the sideline, has to pump it off of Hawkins.
Just trying to attack the hoop, and great box out there. Hines Allen using her derriere a little bit to kind of push things out and get in position.
Vaughn again, that's her third basket. Averages less than 3 points per game on the year.
Wide open at the elbow.
Taking advantage. Turner one-on-one with Hines Allen. Mitchell cuts, short, Atkins the rebound, and she's fouled before she can put it up. Just midway through the first quarter, DC leads Phoenix early. In honor of Kobe Bryant's 42nd birthday, many WNBA players today showing their support, honoring one of the game's best who did all he could to promote the game on all levels in women's basketball. And of course, his impact with his daughter Gianna's team. Just a great moment of recognition. And also, Diana Taurasi, her fallen friend, wearing his name on the back of her jersey. What must be a very emotional day for her, not only losing her friend, but as somebody who grew up in Los Angeles.
And there were so many players that came out, Jewel Lloyd and her relationship with Kobe, Keisha Collier, her relationship with Kobe, obviously Sabrina Ionescu, and the list goes on and on. And they weren't just, you know, random text relationships. They were just true friendships with Kobe Bryant and Gigi, and just sorely missed. Unbelievable 42nd birthday today, and WNBA honoring Kobe all weekend.
Back to the action. Leslie goes back and hits the three. Kiara Leslie making just her second start this year, and after dealing with a nagging injury, has come back and been very active early on both ends. Now dealing with the task of defending Taurasi. Off the screen, she hits it. Her step back three is good. And after a slow start, both offenses starting to get the gears turning.
That timeout helped. Coach is making the adjustments, and Atkins on that play just kind of stepped back away from Hartley a little bit.
Deegan Smith thought she was fouled. Instead, it'll stay here with 12 seconds on the shot clock. In her first season with Phoenix, Deegan Smith averaging nearly 16 points per game. And with Washington's leading scorer heading to the bench, Maisha Hines-Allen, Mercury will try to take advantage. Couple of new subs on the floor for Sandy Brondello. Sophie Cunningham into the shot clock, didn't realize it. And it's another turnover for Phoenix. That's already five in the quarter.
And Sophie Cunningham's gonna have to start feeling comfortable with this pressure. She's gonna see up on the perimeter. Cunningham had been successful in previous games from behind the arc. Certainly, Washington does not want to see her get into a groove with the opportunity from behind the arc tonight.
Leslie dribbles right into the corner and lost the handle and gives it right back. Winningest coach in WNBA history, Mike Tebow, challenging his team. Smith, lob inside. Vaughn gets it to go. She'll head to the line to shoot one.
Kia Vaughn getting herself set early. See her arm raised up, leading in with the ball right there. At that point, she has the true advantage. Coach was actually, the foul could have been called a little bit earlier on her with that push off the backside and trying to near, but eventually hanging with it, staying cool, and now the opportunity at the line.
Made her first start of the year Friday. But in 20 minutes, only put up 3 points. And as she converts the three-point play, Vaughn has 9 of the 14 for Phoenix. Atkins tripped up before she could get going, and the foul charged to Shatori Walker-Kimbrough, the former Mystic who received her championship ring right before tip-off. Trying to create, picks it up. Leilani Mitchell has to throw it up. Nice defense by Deegan Smith to force the miss. Pass inside, Alana Smith has it tipped out of play. Ariel Atkins, the lone starter from last year's championship team, doing everything she can. Keep DC ahead here in the first quarter. Walker Kimbrough starts, stops, can't bank it in.
Gotta go.
An illegal screen called against Hawkins. Appeared as though she may have caught Deegan Smith up high. Each of these teams, you look at them in the standings at number 6 and 10, you might think there's a lot of separation, but only a game and a half difference. Back to Vaughn, and she puts it in again. On fire, 5 of 5 from the floor here in the first quarter.
Some high percentage shots too, inside 15 footers, and she's just converting very easily on every single shot. Got a little bit of a height advantage in taking those shots and getting in a position early.
Downhill, Stella Johnson floats it up and it rolls off. Walker Kimbrough off the screen, pulls up, and connects on another Phoenix three. Walker Kimbrough has certainly been hot and cold this year. But when she's been on, Phoenix has been much tougher to beat. Backdoor cut by Johnson, floats it back out to Atkins, and her three in and out. Final minute of play in the first quarter. Megan Smith running the point with Taurasi and Hartley on the bench. Mitchell timed that perfectly. Going the other way, lays it in for an easy two. High to step the screen. Now running downhill. And a foul called before Walker Kimbrough could get the feed. And that'll bring in Taurasi and Turner for the final possession offensively for Phoenix in the first. So Andy Brondello said that too with a loss on Friday where a team put up 80 points. You just said, we're going to have to find scoring somewhere else.
Yeah, you know, she was pretty, pretty cool about the whole thing. You know, I had that poker face going on today, just about the way that the team has played, and like we'll be all right. That was the feeling I got from listening to her as a coach.
Heave at the buzzer, and Jamelos can't hit. And after the first quarter of play, Phoenix holds a 2-point lead here on Sunday night in Bradenton.
Yvonne right now from the elbow, from the baseline. She is all over the court, just finding some real good spacing right now, Sean. 5 for 5 from the floor, 11 points to lead all scorers, and the first scorer in double figures tonight. Just really looking confident in a fluid motion on the floor for this Phoenix team.
Sandy Brondello said, with no Brittany Griner, we're going to have to find scoring.
Yeah.
a good start as she has more than half the Phoenix points. Blowing right by, Stella Johnson lays it in after going scoreless Friday. One of those players, like Leah mentioned in the first quarter, essentially getting a tryout with the Mystics here. Walker Kimbrough loses the handle, but got it back. Good defense to force the miss. Hines Allen back into the game. Jackie Jamelos, her pass intercepted. Taurasi, lob to Alana Smith. Good contest. Smith wanted the foul, but Washington's flying all over the floor right now to make these even easy ones tough.
They're flying all over the floor because they're getting caught behind. Mike Thibault, when he's running his offense and off over four, he wants you to push that ball up the floor quickly. Washington's not getting any numbers to be able to do that, and then they're getting caught behind to try to recover defensively on Phoenix's move down the floor.
Turner, a little shake and bake, knocks down the turnaround. Johnson, catch and shoot, and she hits it. Leader in points per game in the NCAA this past season at Rider. Five here in the second quarter, and draws the foul to give Washington the ball back. And mentioned it earlier too, Shatori Walker Kimbrough, part of the championship team with the Mystics last year, in a bench role, meeting with her former head coach at center court, finally receiving her championship ring. Always good to see when those former players play against their former team right after winning a title.
That's right. You know, there's tight friendships. They've been through a lot. As soon as the ball goes up, the mentality changes. They want to beat you as bad as you want to beat them. But a special moment and a nice job by the Mystics organization to physically give her her ring prior to the start.
Hines Allen rattles it in. That's what Phoenix doesn't want to see. Something she did in the second half of her last game. And nearly led Washington back from a 23-point deficit. And on the other end, Rossi gets the foul call and will shoot a pair.
Fouls on three, hits on the floor to two, I gotta review it.
Well, now they're going to take a second look at this and review it. Taurasi held to just 3 points there in the first quarter. And we'll wait to see if the call on the floor has changed.
Kind of hard to see at that angle. Looked like she was inside the line there. But we'll see if we get a better look. Well, maybe we won't get a better look at it from that angle.
Roy Gobain and Tiffany Bird taking a second look. And they do change it to a three-shot foul. While Taurasi has been on and off from the field this year, she's been unstoppable from the free throw line, getting 93%. So you're trying to stretch out that back. She missed a couple of games this year and said, you know, I used to be able to walk on the court and play immediately, and now it takes me over 2 hours to get the treatment I need, to stretch out, to get my body prepared, to put it through that rigor of going through a couple hours a day every other day now.
Right, and well, you know, the thing is that Diana understands exactly what she needs to do and focuses in on what she needs to do, and her body talks to her to make sure that she's ready to go. And, you know, it's amazing that they have all the things that they do right now to allow professional players at all levels to be able to do that.
Turner sends it back. It's so great to see Taurasi, also Sue Bird, still playing at such a high level, even this late in their career. We think with some of the young stars, and they're still showing everybody they got game. Is underneath, coach puts it in. Coming off a career high 11 points Friday. Turner caught in traffic. Taurasi pulls up and buries it. 9 points for Taurasi now here in the first half, following her second made three. Jamelos has a step, bullet pass inside, but blocked from behind by Taurasi.
Fell hard on her knee too, doing that. Got it hard, slammed it down. A little volleyball spike there.
Oh, we're on the same page there as Hartley takes it away, hangs and hits. Like something you'd probably see down at the pool in the hotel where a lot of the players are staying at. I didn't see him play a little volleyball in there.
Well, absolutely.
Heinz Allen shot off the mark. Taurasi pushes with Phoenix ahead by two. Pull up. Oh, the Mamba mentality in the first half. Diana Taurasi starting to heat up and giving Phoenix a 5-point lead.
Give her the ball. Give her the ball.
Locked in. Shook Sutton before she can get going. A whistle stops play. There was a clock issue on the floor, and what a sequence for Taurasi these last couple of possessions.
Both ends of the floor swatting it away, getting back up and sizing up the defense right there and having enough space and then draining the three with ease.
Best score all time. You got to pick her up at half court, Leah.
Right. You pick her up at half court, you play her tight, and she, you know, works herself right around you.
Give Taurasi a minute to catch her breath. What a performance. And, you know, she said that in a Good Morning America interview released as we're double checking the clock. And she said, as tragic as it is to lose Kobe, the thing that I can smile at is I can't wait to tell my 2-year-old son, Leo, all the stories that I remember from Kobe and show him all the YouTube videos. I just can't wait when he's old enough to understand his greatness.
Have those memories.
Inside.
You know, the memories are so important. You know, that's memories with pictures, memories with videos. And Diana will be able to share that as Leo grows up.
As Taurasi heads back, Coates will shoot two, and even in the Mystics organization, dealing with a huge loss on their side. Wes Unseld passed away not too long ago. And even what Mike Tebow said as they wear the 41 patch, he was an integral part of the formation of the Mystics. And we appreciate all he did to try to amplify the support in the DC area. After what he did in the same city, hasn't been the same with some of that. Smith, too strong. But it was always great to see those NBA legends give their support for the league. Sees Park for Jamelos, but still can't make it. 2-on-1, Hartley to Smith right through her hands.
Mystics got a huge break, and they continue to struggle, Sean, getting back defensively and these opportunities that Phoenix is having in transition is eventually going to bite them if Washington does not release quicker off those shots.
Well, if Alana Smith does that again, she's going to have to go back to coloring her coach's hair like she did a couple of weeks ago. Long three, and Jamelo sticks it. Been a frustrating start to her Mystics career. She was signed just 4 days ago, but finally makes her first shot.
Thought the Mystics were the best fit for her, was happy that Mike Tebow reached out for her. They were familiar with her during her college days, and a foul on the floor that will lead us to a break.
Former USC Trojan makes it a 2-point game, 5:40 to play in the first half between Phoenix and Washington. Well, before last year's season opener versus Seattle, Phoenix Mercury got a little surprise. Mambacita, some of her teammates, as Kobe Bryant got to the locker room, snapped a couple of photos, got to catch up, and their crazy lives. It's just always great to see whenever Kobe sat courtside. And you know, right now, making the Mamba proud as she has had 12 first half points to lead Phoenix to a 2-point lead.
Three from behind the arc, and of course, the WNBA this year announcing the Kobe and Gigi Bryant WNBA Advocacy Award that will be honored next year at the 2021 NBA All-Star Game.
Dagan Smith, end of the shot clock, loses the handle and harmlessly rolls out of bounds. And an important note, too, that following the game, Diana Taurasi will sign the jersey, and it's going to be available for auction beginning tonight, and it will run through until Tuesday night, 8 p.m. Eastern. You can visit the Phoenix Mercury Twitter or Instagram for more info to know how to bid on this truly one-of-a-kind item. Hawkins on the roll. Snapped in her tracks by Vaughn. And a travel called against Tiana Hawkins.
I think Diana's kicks should go in it as well. Why not, right?
You're starting to sound like me.
Oh, you have not seen the closet collection. A lot of old school in there, but a lot of good stuff.
Well, we'll try to set you up with some J's, I know. Diana, Taurasi, Sue Bird, they can help you out with some of that. Leilani Mitchell called for the foul near midcourt as we just passed the midway point of the second quarter. 2-point game between two teams fighting for playoff position. As weird as that sounds, see what Taurasi's got on tonight. Looking like some LeBron's though. Vaughn right back to work. Nearly had it stripped on the double. Out to Hartley. And can't draw iron. High talent. Trying to get going here. Stops in the lane. Kick out Hawkins. And she knocks down the three to give Washington the lead again.
I tell you what, that play didn't look pretty. You can see Mitchell waving around. Go ahead to the basket. And it was starting to break down. And Hines Allen stuck with it.
Don't adjust your set or remove your glasses. Washington, yes, is 7 of 10 from 3. And a held ball called as Hartley forces the tie-up. That's what it's really been for Washington. It looks out of sync at times, and yeah, they do also have 7 turnovers, but when they've been moving the ball, they've been getting open looks and knocking them down. Coach Tebow looking for a foul after that last whistle. Instead, it'll be Hines Allen and Hartley jumping. Hawkins open again. And a slap all ball by Taurasi, helping deflect that one out of play.
Totally. I think that ball got knocked all the way to the ocean.
Atkins feeds it inside. Leslie, too strong. Battle for the rebound, and it was last touched by the Mystics guard. The rookie, after missing all of last year with a right knee injury, has also been dealing with a couple of naggers here. Been nicked up for a couple of games, but has played strong tonight in just her second career start. She played really well late in the overtime loss to Dallas on Friday. Trying to make the most of this opportunity. Hartley lost her pivot foot and is called for the travel. 11 turnovers for Phoenix. How do they clean some of that up?
Well, and it's focus. That's nothing more than focus. And no matter what Sandy Brundella or her staff says, the group has to collectively get together and refocus themselves in, zone themselves in. And this is where Washington can take advantage of it. Might not be pretty right now, but it's a one-point ball game, and Washington is certainly fully at the, you know, the door is fully open for them to take advantage of the situation.
Taurasi exits as Hartley picks up her first personal. The third team foul in the quarter on the Mercury. Start and stop. Hawkins couldn't get it to drop. Hartley pushes the pace. Inside to Vaughn, was bumped and finishes through contact yet again. Have a half, Kia Vaughn, 6 of 6 with 13 points, making a look at 14 with one more free throw.
Kia kind of made a slight move at the end, and I think that was enough. You bite the defender off of their feet, totally off their feet in Hawkins, and that made it for an easy foul call.
I thought you put it best, Leah. She's getting those high percentage looks because she's putting herself in spots to succeed.
Absolutely. And running, she's running the floor harder than anybody right now to get in a position early for her teammates.
Hines Allen backing down Turner. Came up short. Hartley with the quick cross. And as the rookie one-on-one. Step back Jay on the way. Won't go. Tip to Hines Allen.
Nice.
See it inside. Nice transition break for Washington to tie it up at 35.
And you notice, I don't know if you could see the bench, especially Miesemann, moving her hand rapidly right after that shot by Hawkins, because she's got to be able to run back up the floor, because Phoenix will take advantage of that in transition. Good job by Hawkins to finish the play and keep this one knotted up at 35.
I wish I could tell them again, that I just love him and appreciate him for everything that he did for me, and who he was as a man, as a player, as a father, as a husband. And, you know, I will never forget our time together, our conversations together. I'm going to continue to live out the mama way.
Jewel Lloyd, one of several players in the WNBA wearing 24. And what a season for her and her Storm team, as she has had some great scoring performances that I know would make her old friend and mentor so proud. After slitting the pair at the line, excuse me, Turner gives Phoenix the 1-point lead. Atkins can't hit her third three of the half. Hartley slithers inside, too strong with the right hand. Vaughn finally misses her first shot after making the first six.
Thought she was hit on the arm on that one.
Atkins. Back to Hawkins. Slips inside, great contest by Turner. Megan Smith gets it right back. And a travel called on Vaughn, as neither she nor Diggins Smith could figure out what to do on that possession. A little too unselfish.
Sounds like, you know, sometimes it's a hot potato. Everybody trying to be unselfish, like you said. But, you know, overall, I think Sandy Brondella has to be very pleased with the unselfishness of her team and the good spots that they've gotten themselves into tonight. As far as passing the basketball,
Hawkins puts in the 8-3 of the half by Washington, shooting 62% from downtown. Hartley gets around the defense, a little too strong with the scoop. Final minute of play here in the second quarter. Very little separation all half between these two playoff hopeful teams. Into the corner, Leslie. Just short. Taurasi looking to extend her 12-point total. She finds Hartley inside. Can't bank it in. And Taurasi uses one at midcourt. She and Hartley disappointed in not getting that foul call. And Hartley, someone who's been tremendous this year with four 20-point games.
Diana talking to anybody that'll listen to her right now. She stopped to talk to Mike Tebow. She stopped to talk to Asia Jones.
She'll see him in the lobby later, right?
Exactly.
Another foul on the inbound. That's going to send Washington to the line.
And I'm sure Mike Tebow said, now you know how I feel.
Goat doing goat things, right? And they're going to check to see if the foul occurred before the inbounds pass.
You see Miesemann with her arms on her hips there in dress clothes tonight. Still nursing that sore shoulder that she had injured 2 games ago.
Washington announcing this weekend that Ariel Powers has been shut down for the season due to a lingering hamstring issue, where Mike Tebow even said there's no point to force her back. You know, we understand where we're at right now. We want her to be healthy. It's not worth the risk. The scrappy Washington team on its way to a 2-point lead in the final minute. And as Roy Gulbayan makes the decision on the court, we'll see if Washington's going to get free throws and a chance to extend the lead.
Therefore, it's one free throw and and possession Washington.
So they are going to say it was a foul on Hartley before the inbound. Leilani Mitchell hits the one free throw, and Washington will have a chance to throw it in yet again. But that's how you can see sometimes you have that frustration foul to stop play, and it just totally takes you out of rhythm. Phoenix trying to reset. Washington, Atkins, can't extend the 12-4 run. 5 second differential in the final minute of the half. Taurasi was bumped by Atkins before the drive.
Diana was directing traffic before that ball even left her hands to go to the top. She was trying to shade Sophie Cunningham to cut towards the hoop and use a little bit of a screen to open herself up. Throwing a little English on that one as she releases it.
And now 5 of 5 at the line. Timeout called by Mike Tebow with his team leading by one, and the shot clock turned off. Diana Taurasi's 14 points helping bring Phoenix back in the final minute of the first half. To do here?
Well, I would like to see them work something to Hines Allen down low on the block. There's plenty of time for her to try to convert on a three-point play and just kind of cut to the hoop here, get something right in the middle of the key.
Mitchell back to Hawkins, whips it inside. Hines Allen can't get it to go before the final buzzer. And after 20 minutes, Washington takes a one-point lead into the locker room over Phoenix. But Diana Taurasi starting to come alive at certain points. It's going to take a big effort from Hines Allen and Washington to come away with win number 5 this year. And coming up, we have a great tribute honoring Kobe Bryant on his 42nd birthday with ESPNW.
lost potentially the greatest ally that this sport could ever hope for.
He was the one that was providing legitimacy to our game. Other people didn't see that. He was changing that narrative.
I would say the most important imprint he's left is just having us feel equal. I mean, he believed in women's sports.
What defines a legacy? Is it stats, championships, a mindset? Kobe Bryant had it all. But for women's basketball, perhaps the most important thing he left behind is inspiration.
As a WNBA player, every day we face so many stigmas and stereotypes. That entire narrative that women are less than, women don't deserve visibility, that was going away with Kobe just simply walking into arena and cheering us on.
He came to a lot of our games. He was at our All-Star game last year. He went to UConn games. He went to an Oregon game. Kobe was like, how do you get more fans in seats? Now that everyone knows how he was mentoring and sponsoring these elite women athletes in the WNBA, I think Kobe's legacy helps us be more innovative around that.
What can I say? Mamba out.
I think the minute he was finished playing, it was, okay, I took everything out of this game that I could possibly take. How do I help other players get better? This incredible amount of women's basketball players had a chance to work with him, and he imparted whatever knowledge he had about the game. And they came away thinking, he's a fan, and he wants us to get better, and he stays in contact with you. Hey, I watched you play the other night. Who does that? He did.
This was a second act for Kobe. Why would he say to Adam Silver, I don't want to talk about the NBA, I want to talk about the WNBA, and I want to meet the new commissioner, you know, and I'm 6 weeks into the job.
It was just in his DNA to try to be great at everything. I think we only saw it through the lens of basketball for so long. He was like, okay, I'm transitioning from giving my all on the court to giving my all to my daughter's mom.
Him being able to coach his team and have his daughter on that team, I think, was huge for him. He wanted to be the best father, but also the best coach that he could. And so I think through his daughter, he was able to do that.
We'll never truly know how far Kobe could have taken his second act. But what we do know is that basketball lost more than just a legend and the future star that Gianna could have been.
He was really as much proud of the fact that she had that drive. Forget, like, she's going to be a really good ball handler, she's going to be a real good shooter, you know, all this stuff. She has that drive, she has the passion, she has the intensity level. And I saw all that when she was at practice, and she was looking at everything, and she's just staring at, like, what plays are they running? You know, what's this kid doing? What's that kid doing? And then when we played in Dallas and we lost, I got a letter from her, and I'll show it to you. Dear Gino and team, I'm so sorry you lost, but it gives you extra time to practice and get better before the next one. Just think, when you think you can't, you can. Love, Gianna Bryant, Gigi.
As we learn to accept what the sports world is like without him, one thing is certain. Kobe Bryant may have just been scratching the surface, and his legacy will continue to ignite the popularity of women's hoops.
He wanted to do more. He wanted to get more involved. He wanted to expand Mamba Academy and dig deeper into it and just add more layers to it. In that area, with those kids, the imprint is immeasurable. You know, they don't remember as much Kobe, the guy fist pumping because he just won an NBA championship. They remember him sitting on the bench trying to get them to be better, or him being in practice trying to show them something.
The rest of my life, everything that I'm going to do, I'm going to make sure that he stays close. And so from here on out, really, everything's going to be for him and what he taught me.
He's always respected and co-signed our game. But after he retired, we started piecing it together. We're like, this is our greatest male ally. Him coming to our games, him bringing his daughter, has truly helped our game grow in ways that we didn't even imagine. And it's unfortunate that we recognize this once it's gone. But the beautiful thing is that now we have so many people that should be warriors and people that want to carry on his legacy forever. And that's the beauty in the tragedy.
Everybody off tomorrow in the WNBA, but the top four teams going head-to-head coming up this week. LA fresh off, coming back from a 10-point deficit today against Dallas. We'll take on Minnesota once again, and Las Vegas and Seattle will meet after the Aces took down the Storm yesterday. When we return, the second half between Washington and Phoenix. Washington taking a one-point lead into the second half thanks to catching fire from deep in the opening 20 minutes.
54% from behind the arc were the Washington Mystics, and they really set the tempo early. I think hitting those threes early on in this game actually helped them to open up the inside game as we progressed through the second quarter of play.
Aisha Hines-Allen only has 5 points going into the third quarter, but her 8 rebounds and 6 assists is what really worked well for Washington as she calls her number here. And fading away comes up short to start the third. Taurasi lobs inside, Turner finishes. And a steal on the inbound, but Diggin Smith couldn't finish it. Phoenix still leads by one, though. Trying to snap a three-game losing streak here in the second half. Atkins back to Hawkins. And she drains another triple. It's her third one on 5 attempts tonight. Taurasi can't answer. Finds Allen, who's been doing everything for the Mystics this year. The Lonnie Mitchell right back to Hines-Allen.
Great ball movement there by the Mystics. They didn't come away with the bucket, but much better motion. Just like this at the opposite end of the floor. And Tia Vaughn leads off where she started in the first quarter of play.
Crossed 2,000 career points on one of her last buckets in the second quarter. Big milestone for her, but clearly not slowing down here on a career day. Mitchell goes right through the double team and pulls her knees. Diggin Smith flares to the corner and puts in her first three. Timeout called by Washington. We step aside and Phoenix retakes the lead thanks to Diana Taurasi's playmaking. already been a great day of basketball in the WNBA. Three games so far. Titans, Phoenix, and Washington trying to continue this close race throughout the second half.
Well, in that Minnesota game, they were up by as many as 14 in that game, and Atlanta came all the way back. And Ajulani almost had a triple-double with 16 points, 10 assists, and 8 boards. And a big win for Atlanta. They needed it from Ren. And then, of course, Candace Parker and the Sparks being able to hold on for a 3-point victory against Dallas. She comes in with another double-double again.
Hawkins lays it in, taking over the scoring load for the Mystics. And even the Sparks came back from a 10-point deficit in the fourth quarter. Vaughn has been loving that spot today. She misses, and Turner with a second chance. Back to Taranti. Her three is good.
Extra pass, Sean. Extra pass. Wide open to Taranti.
Four threes for the GOAT. As we see some back and forth here between these two teams, both really needing a win in this first two matchup for the next 5 days. Atkins turns the corner, puts it up, and nearly banked it in. Instead, she'll head to the line for two shots. And how about Phoenix, number one in assist percentage this year?
Hartley got him to bite. Once the defense got off their feet, two players committed, made that easy pass to Taranti.
Coach Brondello looking for a little bit of an explanation.
And she was as intense as a coach as she was as a player back in her day.
All smiles right now with her team still leading by one in this tight ball game. Atkins sinks the pair, giving her 10 points on the game. Megan Smith been running the point most of the game. Puts it up. Mitchell pushes the tempo. Mitchell back to Hines Allen. Late in the shot clock, she drives. Too strong. Hawkins, though, turns and hits.
Hawkins has been super at running the floor, getting herself up ahead for rebounds, and really being active on the glass for this Mystics team. Go, 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 gotta go.
Nice save by Turner. Diggins commits the foul. And once again, take a look at our updated standings. Not a lot of breathing room between the top five and even six through 10. A game and a half separates Phoenix and Washington in those spots respectively.
Since the start of the day, 4 and 5 have flipped. The Sky split up one and the Lynx down one. That's the difference of having one of those byes as we progress along in the season.
Even that double bye can be crucial. High Allen drains another 53. They're now 10-17 in the game. Taranti pulls up. Can't get it to go. Sierra Leslie, though, has it. For DC, it's now a 5-point lead. Mitchell slips inside, blocked by Smith. Chases down the rebound. Breakdown defensively. An air ball that Hines Allen at the end of the shot clock lifts it in. And it's now a 7-point Washington lead. Washington starting to break through in the second half. It's been a tough couple of games for the Mystics, but they're fighting and clawing and now have their largest lead of the game. All around phenomenal performance so far by Myesha Hines-Allen, starting to flirt with the triple-double, and everything she's done has helped this team.
Third WNBA season, third WNBA team. And certainly for Myesha Hines-Allen, he has turned into a rock star veteran role with his team, with the injuries and the movement of different players. And you can just tell she looks so much more comfortable and fluid on the floor for Washington.
A big three out of the timeout by Alana Smith to end the Washington run. Near the end of the shot clock, Hawkins kicks it out to Hines-Allen. Smith collects the rebound, looking for a little help in the backcourt. Just past the midway point, the third. Hartley back out to Smith. Another three. That one in and out. Hesitation by Hartley, and it works to perfection as she gets the and one.
Bree Hartley made noise off the top of our broadcast, and a good job here. And the mismatch with Lonnie Mitchell. Go back up strong.
Second foul on Mitchell. Third on Washington here in the quarter. Just like that, back to a one-point game after it was 7 moments ago. Atkins pulls up, can't get it. Atkins though with the follow. Tying her season high now with 17 points in the game. Taurasi, no look pass, but Turner wasn't ready for it in traffic. Hines-Allen ahead of the pack, denied.
It's a pretty stellar minutes.
And there is somebody who's going to see a lot more PT for Phoenix.
Yeah.
And in certain spots this year, she has thrived for Sandy Brondello. And helped force the turnover seconds later.
I love it. Great hustle play, good work. 10 minutes of action, and she has been all over the floor. 3 assists, 3 steals, 2 blocks. AL throwing a couple of points in as well. That's utilizing your minutes on the floor.
Rossi beats inside. Turner was juggling it and somehow had it long enough to lay it in. Mitchell the other way. Hawkins passed them, tipped out of play. How about the ball movement by Phoenix?
Quick, sharp pass, and almost a little bit of a hot potato there for Turner to handle.
Phoenix leads the WNBA, assisting on nearly 70% of its baskets. No assists there as Mitchell misses the three. And right now, 15 assists on 20 made shots. Turner off balance, forces up the wild shot. Taurasi uses another foul. It'll be her third personal. You like her thin? Take one of those in the second half?
Pardon me? I couldn't hear you there.
Do you like seeing Taurasi take one of those fouls? It's now her third.
Well, yeah, I think it's a good waste ball, and it doesn't hurt the situation. It actually slows the Mystics down.
Hines-Allen one-on-one with Turner. Backing down inside to Leslie, and another block for Alana Smith. Call in the SWAT team as she has her third block. And Taurasi knocks down the jumper to give Phoenix the lead again. A 10-2 run for Phoenix since the timeout. Atkins on the handoff, buries it, and just like that, Washington leads again, following the 11th made three of the game. Smith to an open Hartley. Breakdown defensively by Washington. Under 2 minutes in the third quarter. Mitchell with Hartley in her face misses. And Atkins taps it out of the hand.
Lock time, lock party, and then Diana Taurasi able to help out at the upper end. Nice job with Smith on the assist on Hartley, and she has been all over the floor tonight in a short period of time to keep this Mercury team within striking distance in her second WNBA season.
Doing all she can with limited front court depth. Taurasi, and hits. And crashing in, Vaughn smacks it out of play. This Phoenix team looking to snap a three-game losing streak. They need to be consistent. Yeah, that was your key, and that's what Sandy Brondello said after a 10-point loss Friday to Minnesota. Jamelo's inside 10. Flipped it to Hawkins. The defense backing off, can't hit. And a foul is going against Phoenix here on the rebound. First foul on Bond, and the first in the last 2 minutes. Bella Johnson wants to go inside. And a blocking foul called against Smith. That will put Washington at the line.
Smith trying to deny that baseline move, and
already seen two close games in the WNBA tonight. It looks like we're going to see another one come down to the final possessions. And that means we're going to see an emphasis on free throw shooting in these final 11 minutes. Two and two for Hawkins. Megan Smith only has 5 points tonight. And a foul behind the arc. That'll be Stella Johnson's first personal foul.
Yeah, Stella Johnson trying to go over the top to get through the screen.
Quickly inside, Megan Smith fouled going up. Hawkins charged her third personal. Another 90% shooter for Phoenix steps up. And that one goes in and out. A rare miss from Skylar Diggins-Smith. One of four players averaging 15 points and 4 assists per game. Two of the others, Taurasi and Hartley in the fourth. Renaja Laney, who had an incredible all-around performance to lead Atlanta to a win today. Mitchell draws the mismatch. Goes back to Mitchell, and she knocks down the three.
Leilani's been quiet for a while, and she's not afraid to step back deep behind that three-point line. They gotta respect my three ball.
Just three off of the season high of 15 made threes that they had to win against Seattle to start the season. Megan Smith late in the shot clock. Drives, puts it up, but a shot clock violation against Phoenix.
6 seconds on the game clock.
15 turnovers for the Mercury here at the end of the third quarter.
And that has been a problem, that third quarter of play for Phoenix. We've seen them unravel several times this year where they've just lost their cohesiveness.
DeMellos to Mitchell. Final second, gets the screen, tosses it up, and it harmlessly crawls off the backboard. But it's Washington makes 12 three-pointers, taking a four-point lead into the fourth quarter. We got a good one tonight in Bradenton. Come back when we start the fourth quarter on the other side.
The veteran out of Maryland, Deanna Hawkins, 26 minutes of action. And working with Hines Allen here, being able to convert on the plays. And the duo has been stellar. Hines Allen with the double-double right now, 10 points, 11 boards. And Deanna Hawkins with 19 points on the night for this Washington team.
Mystics trying to improve to 5-8 to stay in the playoff hunt. While Phoenix is trying to snap a game losing streak. Vaughn passes out of the double team. Smith draws the blocking foul as they're going to point the restricted area. Strong cut by Smith. And I know we were just saying it before the end of the third quarter. Her strong play is what helped Phoenix come back from what was a 7-point deficit in the third.
Absolutely. She's been filling up the box in a lot of ways, not only with her scoring, but with her defensive effort and being able to come away with some steals and some key blocks along the way. She has been a real pleasant surprise for the Mercury off the bench tonight.
You could clearly see Hines Allen in the restricted area. That was her third personal foul in the opening minute of the fourth quarter. 2-2 at the line for Smith. And the deficit cut in half. The rookie shoots, Stutton brings it up for Washington. Digs out Hines Allen, had a step, and instead throws it away. Walker Kimbrough races ahead of the pack. Can't lay it in. Diggins Smith follows, and we are tied. Bella Johnson, another rookie. Back out to Hines Allen with space. Can't drain it. An offensive rebound for Elena Coates.
I thought Coates would have been best suited, Sean, going right back up with it there.
Now the three. Why get two when you can get three, Leah?
Right, and be impatient on it, too.
Double foul called underneath.
Sugg just looking to get acclimated as well. We'll take a look at it from the corner. And that extra pass, and Sugg just getting some PT in and getting acclimated herself in a Washington uniform. Still getting accustomed to the system and to the playbook for this Washington Mystic team.
It's been the confidence of some of these rookies. Smith called for the illegal screen. And it's what a lot of teammates complimented even Stella Johnson about. She played four games and six total minutes with Chicago and was even drafted by Phoenix in the second round of this year's draft. But when everything was turned upside down due to COVID, a lot of rookies didn't get the chance to work out, try out, make rosters. Essentially being a season-long tryout to showcase they can play in this league.
That's exactly right. And this type of atmosphere actually works, I think, very well for the rookies as far as night in and night out with different scouts and different teams.
Smith inside. Got bumped. Lonzo, the offensive rebound. Trying to outlet. Gives it right to Johnson. Trying to cross up to Rossi. Got too excited seeing the one-on-one opportunity with
Oh yeah, oh my. What big eyes you have.
A nice move by Taurasi to draw the foul, and she will shoot three.
But Diana's expression was priceless. Like, are you kidding me right now? You're gonna try to cross me up? Stella Johnson, we had an opportunity to hear from her prior to our last game with Washington. I believe it was against Indiana. Everything's getting a little mumbo-jumbo into mine. But, you know, she had said that, you know, she just felt comfortable with Mike Tebow. And you see Taurasi here trying to work on Johnson at the opposite end.
Those are the all things you learn when you become the greatest scorer of all time. And Johnson, who is the best scorer in the NCAA this past season, still realizing she can learn a thing or two.
Absolutely.
As you saw earlier this week, Johnson, no slouch herself, set the WNBA rookie record with 6 threes and 25 points in her first career start. All tied up at 68, a couple of minutes into the fourth. Sutton with five on the shot clock. Drives inside and was fouled by Diggins Smith. Backbreaker for Phoenix. They're playing so well most of that possession. Line up, please. That'll be her second personal foul. But already the third team foul on Phoenix. Okay, Sutton goes 1 of 2, the number 36 pick by Washington in this year's draft out of Texas. Bad pass from Smith looking for Taurasi. And the fourth team foul on Phoenix. Next foul will be free throws for the rest of the quarter.
Right.
Remember, Washington, although 6 of 9 today at the line, number 3 in free throw percentage in the WNBA this year. Johnson, quickly off the inbound, drive, and hit the floater.
Great job to drive the middle.
Seven points for Johnson off the bench. And under 7 to play in the fourth. Out to Taurasi, catch and shoot, and he parries it. 25 for Diana Taurasi. And important to note, Phoenix 3-0 this year when she scores 20 or more. Doing all she can to keep Phoenix in this and snap a 3-game losing streak tonight. Jamelos, horrible.
Oh, almost picked away there too.
Another pull up, and another hit. Wearing the Kobe jersey tonight.
And keep in mind that jersey's going to be auctioned off too after this game.
Hines Allen backing down Turner. Goes into the sweep and pops it right to Taurasi. Megan Smith put on the gas. Draws the foul.
You feel the momentum, you feel the push right now. Phoenix is really pushing the ball down the throat of this Mystics team. 28 points for Diana Taurasi, taking it over in Kobe's honor.
Used, rebroadcast, or otherwise used in any form without the express written consent of WNBA Enterprises.
Diana Taurasi, we talked about her lighting it up from different parts of the floor. Just give me the ball. 28 points, 6 for 11 from 3. It's just so smooth, Sean. You know, you need a bucket. You can depend on Diana Taurasi. Just put the ball in her hands, and she just takes control and kind of eases the pressure off of this team when it needs to be taken off. But the pace right now, I think, really is flowing back towards Phoenix's side. They are dictating the motion. They're starting to gas the Mystics just a little bit with their fluid motion on the floor.
Two free throws for Diggins Smith out of the timeout. She joins Vaughn and Taurasi in double figures for Phoenix. Trying to pull it together and improve to 7-7. Jamelo sent to the shot clock, trying to step through, and a foul is called. In the final seconds, once again, Leah, Phoenix fouls when it looked like they had strong positioning.
Totally bailed out. Kia Vaughn mystified on that play. And now, Mystics need to be able to convert on this. And, you know, Jackie Jamelo is another player who just comes into the opportunity to play for the Washington Mystics. Shot clock winding down, and might have been just barely touched on the arm there.
Jamelo's waived Monday by Connecticut, signed Wednesday. Really another Phoenix turnover. Barely get it across before the 8-second violation. As Hartley was tight-roping the sideline. Fouls called against Washington. And now Hines Allen's is fourth personal foul. For Ariel Atkins, it's her third personal. And Phoenix going to be in the bonus for the next 5:18 of the game. And that's the last person you want to see at the line right now,
right,
if you're a Mystics fan.
Phoenix is a team. It really wouldn't matter who you put at the line tonight for Phoenix. They have all been exceptional from the free throw line.
I beg your pardon. That was the fifth foul earlier on Hines Allen. So she heads to the bench with just over 5 minutes to play. Jamelos can't hit, but a second chance. Trying to work on Turner. Maneuvers inside and has it locked.
Here, Phoenix side, a go-go with the ball.
Hartley whistled her way in for two.
All right into the middle of the floor, and that's going to force Mike Tebow into timeout.
Timeout, Mike Tebow. It's now a 7-point Phoenix lead. Starting to surge ahead. Leah, if you're Mike Tebow, what are you telling your team to get back on track?
You've got to protect the basketball, number one, and number two, when the ball is going up. Washington, once again, is not breaking quickly enough as soon as that ball is going up to think about going the opposite way. And Phoenix, two or three steps ahead of them at that point for easy buckets the opposite way.
Trying to communicate on the floor with Hines Allen on the bench. Wouldn't you bring her back, Lee, especially now down 7?
Well, I think it'll probably be around the 3:20 mark at that point. But, you know, this possession will dictate how quickly she comes back off the bench.
Maybe try to play it, giving her a little bit of extra rest. Bring her back at the under 3 if it's not too late. Hawkins stepping back. That one rolls off. Tap back to Mitchell, and she puts it in. Oh, Washington will take anything with its leading scorer on the bench. Taurasi rises, can't hit. Mitchell pushed back by Vaughn. Everyone recovers for the Mercury defense. Johnson slips in and puts it in with the left hand.
Fortunately for
now has nine.
Yeah, fortunately for Stella Johnson, able to go to her strong side to the left. Phoenix was constantly looking for that pick and roll action, and it wasn't happening. And a good, strong move by Stella Johnson. Aisha Hines-Allen has done a little bit of everything tonight, trying to lead Washington back to the win column after a heartbreaking loss Friday. But right now, watching from the sidelines the last couple of minutes, we wait to see if Mike Thibault is going to bring her back in the next couple of possessions as DC has trimmed a 7-point deficit down to 3, which forced the Phoenix timeout. Yeah, that was a big basket by, I believe it was Kalai Mitchell, on the play, and I think that that's going to give Mike Thibault just a little bit of a breather here, more for Hines-Allen, depending on what happens here. I would say like around the 3:20 mark, 3-minute mark, at the most.
Taurasi hits another one. 7 threes tonight. You cannot write a script like this. 33 points, but a whistle. Stop play. Washington will take it out of bounds.
Diana working hard. Come through that screen. Good job as the screener was trying to come underneath.
Carrying a little bit of Kobe with her tonight. In this monster 33-point performance. But just a 6-point lead as we near 3 minutes to play. Atkins creates space but gives it back to Mitchell. 2 on the shot clock. And Washington can't get a shot off before the buzzer. Good closeout by Sophie Cunningham, who just checked into the game. He's only played 11 minutes on the night. Hines Allen couldn't get to the table in time and will have to wait until the next whistle to check in. Pass inside, taken away by Johnson and into the hands of Hawkins. Mitchell drives inside and hits the bounce.
You know, and that was exactly what the Mystics needed to do last scenario down the floor when they came away with no points. Get to the middle of the floor, get to the basket, try to attack, or possibly get to the line.
All alone, Breonna Turner lays it in. Mitchell, too strong. Turner soars for the rebound. Rossi lost the dribble, Pope lays out on the floor, and a jump ball is called, and that'll bring in Hines Allen for Washington and Diggin Smith for Phoenix as Taurasi comes up limping after losing the handle.
Pile of players went down for that basketball.
2:03 to play in regulation. These two teams separated by 1.5 games. In the standings, Washington currently at 10th place, and Phoenix in 6th. Waiting to see what the stoppage is on the court.
I believe it's over the shot clock.
See if possession did change.
And actually checking on the substitutions.
Turner and Coates to jump, and it tapped into the hands of Atkins. And immediately another whistle. Hartley clearly frustrated after being called for her fourth personal foul. And even that last one at midcourt will put Atkins at the line. 90% foul shooter. And after the first, Hines Allen will officially come back in.
And returning for the Mystics, Kiera Wesley, replacing Stella Johnson.
Now 15 points on the game for Ariel Atkins. Back to a four-point game with 2 minutes to play. Smith steps back and has that one rattling in and out. Mitchell peels back out. Now late in the shot clock, they give it to Atkins. Jumper on the way, and that's good. Ariel Atkins leading Washington back. It's down to a 2-point Phoenix lead. Taurasi off the handoff. And a foul called on the shot.
Foul's on number one.
Washington being very patient, trying to look for that higher percentage shot and the opportunity. Atkins with the big one, keeping her team close right now. Unfortunately, at the other end of the floor, a foul was called. They'll take a look at it.
1:16 left in the fourth quarter. You want to get it right.
Right.
Our crew chief, Roy Gobain, will put the headset on. Tiffany Bird watches over his shoulder. What a triple header it has been in the WNBA today. Earlier this afternoon, Atlanta came back from a 14-point second half deficit. Los Angeles stormed back from a 10-point fourth quarter deficit to defeat Dallas. And now Phoenix trying to hang on and snap a three-game losing streak against Washington. And they put Diana Taurasi, who is 10 of 10 at the line tonight, shooting three. What a performance it has been by Taurasi. A new season high. And finally misses a free throw.
Got one more, though.
Even before that, Phoenix was 20 of 22. Just one of three at the line for Taurasi. Smith battles.
Smith has really been battling in her 19 minutes of action tonight.
Each team still has two timeouts remaining. Atkins wants in the one possession game. Five on the timer. Working with a switch on Smith. Caught in the corner, has to heave. And a foul called. It appears to be on Alana Smith.
See if we can see if the shot clock was actually off. Very difficult to see, obviously, from that angle of the floor there. And that's what they're going to check, if the shot was off before or after the square.
I know that's where it's just such a fine line, Leah, in giving a shooter the space to land. And it doesn't appear like there was a lot of contact, but you could see the foot of Atkins still making contact. And I know you also want to close out on a shooter like her. It's just so difficult to defend, but we've seen this several times from Phoenix in the second half where they're a little too eager to jump out.
Right.
Officials wait, try to see if the shot clock buzzer went off before Atkins put up the shot. A big swing, potentially, on this next call. And another timeout for each coach.
Yeah, totally. This is a long, extended opportunity for each coach to go over the next 52 seconds. They've made a decision.
Roy Gobain, Tiffany Bird, Carlina Tobin. Coach Tebow just trying to nudge and say, no, that wasn't a three. You sure? So the fourth personal foul on Alana Smith stands. And two shots coming for Atkins. Free throws matter. Like we said, it's coming down to the final foul shots here with 53 seconds to play. One and two at the line. Turner pulls in the rebound. That's her 15th of the game. And you know who wants the ball in her hands. Driving inside, has to kick it out.
Okay. Still limping a little bit on that right foot, too.
Hartley fading away. Won't go. Offensive rebound. Rossi trying to pull through. step back on the way. It's short. Hines down the rebound. Racing up the floor. Steps up. Has it tipped away. Rebound to Turner. Partly ahead of the pack. Lays it in. What a finish on that last possession.
Flurry down at the other end. Diana Taurasi was unable to make that jumper. They get the board. Hines Allen with an opportunity here at the hoop. Can't put it down. And then Hartley just making it look easy, going in for the easy two. Just deflating any hopes that the Mystics might have had.
Trying to fight through after getting dinged up earlier in the quarter when she took a fall on a loose ball. But you know Diana Taurasi is not going to ask to be subbed out. She's going to fight through it.
Sandy Brundello saying, don't fight and jump off your feet. Stay down, stay on the play.
What a tightly contested game this has been. A few bounces one way. It's helped Phoenix stay ahead. And one final huddle for Taurasi, speaking to the troops. Wearing the number 8 tonight instead of the usual 3.
Totally representing, and in case you joined us late, in honor of Kobe Bryant, his 42nd birthday today, that jersey will be raffled off after this game.
And go to the Phoenix Mercury Facebook page or Twitter account for more information on that. For the auction, that will start momentarily following the game. Atkins to inbound. And to Johnson, puts it up and knocks it down. And they're going to check the clock. It appears like there was a little bit of time left. Because, of course, Leah, in this game, you know it's not going to be easy for Phoenix to shake hands and walk away.
No, no. And again, you know, this goes with the records and everything that kind of goes in inside the wobble this year. Just every game is like a playoff championship-type setting. And this is the best opportunity for these players to prepare for what lies ahead come the playoff weeks. And I can't even believe we're already heading down the final stretch of the year as they take a look at it once again to see exactly how much time is left on the game clock.
It's crazy to think the regular season ends in 20 days. But the first of two games in the next 5 days between Phoenix and Washington, it has come down to the wire. In a matter of tenths of a second. They're going to put 2/10 of a second back on the clock. Warriors inbound, and they'll improve to 7-7. And that's the ball game. Phoenix hangs on to win 88-87 in a thriller where Diana Taurasi put the team on her back and put up 34 points and was 7 of 13 from downtown.
Taurasi started off early, set the tempo with the threes. Looking so smooth as usual, just wanting the ball in her hands, taking control of this team and the game. Speed and tempo of this Phoenix team, no question tonight. Certainly the difference. Diana Taurasi wearing the number 8 proudly for the game this evening.
What a performance. Stepping up and taking over in crunch time. Every wait Taurasi to join us after an emotional victory on what would have been Kobe Bryant's 42nd birthday. We now say hello to Diana Taurasi. And Diana, I have to ask you, as a Los Angeles native, what did it mean to you to put that jersey on today?
I was hesitant.